For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see about NFS server and client installation and configuration. So what does mean by the NFS? NFS in the sense network file system. This network file system is used to share your drive from the one server to the other clients, and where the clients can mount that file system as their local drive across the multiple nodes or the multiple clients, so that whenever you wanted to share one software to the most of the clients and install it, it would be easier to share one NFS share from the server, or the one NFS export from the server, then mount it to the multiple clients and store one file, then you can able to see into the all the clients, and simple using the small scripts, you can install the patches or install some updates or install some softwares, you can do using that. Yes, so how you can install it and configure the NFS server over here. So the NFS server in RHCL7, we are going to install it and configure it. Here our environment currently, I'm going to show you, here it is that NFS server is going to be 192.168.2.43. So the server is going to be a 192.168.2.43, and the client NFS client is going to be 192.168.2.49. So I'm going to share export from the NFS server, and I'm going to mount it into the client. So here the NFS NFS is used in Linux is to share the files and directories, share the directories to the multiple servers. So where this standalone NFS server do not have any security, in the sense does not require any authentication like username, password to connect to that NFS, but it's based on the IP address. Whenever you export it, the export is can be exported using the IP address or the network CID, so that all the network systems can be accessible using that IP address. Okay, so later point of time over here going to secure the NFS, we are also going to see that. So the basically the packages required to install over here, it is that NFS utils and daemon, in the sense the service name is to be nfs-service.service, and the port number, by default port number of the NFS is 2049. Okay, and the configuration file is going to be /etc/exports. So now just install NFS utils. A dependency is going to be installed, the NFS utils is installed. Now systemctl enable nfs-service or nfs server dot service. Okay, it's enabled, and now you can going to be start this NFS server, right? NFS server is failed to start. What happened? Because I think it did not have any configuration over here, failed to start the NFS service. To start the services, we have to do verify the RPC bind service, so which is not started. Okay, we will start this RPC bind service. RPC bind. No such a file or directory, sorry, RPC bind. Okay, and we are going to restart the server again, restart NFS server dot service. Now you can see this system CTL status NFS-server. So this is what we have to do. We have to enable the firewall ports. Okay, firewall -cmd -permanent. I'm just going to write the service equal to NFS and also mount d and also RPC -bind. These are the services must be enabled to mount this NFS to the remote server, and I'm going to make some directory called NFS server, something like that. Okay, this NFS server, okay, I'm just going to change this permission to the NFS nobody, because the NFS nobody is the service account name where it's going to be have the full control on the server, that NFS services. Okay, and I'm just going to change these permissions. Okay, 770 and slash NFS server, because whenever I would like to mount the remote session, I have to have the read and write permissions over there. So that's why, and slash it is slash exports is the configuration file where you have to specify this directory path which one you would like to export. Okay, directory path and which system you are going to exporting. Example, say the 192.168.2.49, or maybe you can also use total subnet mask value and what is the permissions you are going to use over here. So here you can also use sync, something like this, read and write sync, so that the NFS would be auto sync in between. Okay, or else you can also just specify the read write would be also fine. Now my export is exported. So in order to verify these exports, okay, just to run export fs, export fs -avr, so that you can see this. This is the exporting from the server to total network. So whatever the network in series, you can able to mount that into this NFS. So now client. So here you just to show that show mount -e and provide the server IP address 2.43, and you could able to see show mount is command is not found. Okay, show mount what provides show mount, because we need to know that what is the package need to be installed. So NFS utils is the package which provide the show mount command. So m install and install this NFS utils. Okay, NFS utils package is not installed. Now again I'm just going to run this show mount -e command. Now you can see this, the exposed list from that server is NFS server which is exported to the all the network. Okay, now just mount this directory over here using the mount command. Mount -t, specify the file system as -o -o. You just specify sync over here, or else you already provided the sync, you no need to provide over here. Okay, anyway I'm just providing the sync over here, say 43 is the server name, and provide this directory path which one you are exporting. This is the one you are exporting, right? You just provide that name and where you would like to mount that one, slash media. Now you can just type dffnh. You can see this, the path has been mounted, and you can see this entire the files. Okay, just go into the slash media over here, and now you can mount, create some files, test line, something like this. So you can see this, both the files you can able to write to that NFS. Now you can just go to the server and go into the NFS server and see this, both the files has been created. You can verify that ownership has been done from the NFS nobody, because the NFS nobody is the service account which you have using for this NFS service to be start and stop and NFS permissions, all this stuff. In order to permanently mount this one, what you have to do is that just edit this FS tab entry slash etc slash FS tab over here and just write that file path over here. Okay, so how you have to write? You have to write this entire path from here to here and provide this file system. Okay, which path you would like to mount to slash media and file system is NFS and defaults and 0 and 0. That's it. And type mount -a, you can see that. Okay, just you mount it slash media and type mount -a to confirm whether our mount point is working perfectly or not. That's it. That's about it. NFS server and client configuration. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.